Okay, hello class 10. So we are going to do the second part of the chapter 7, that is Mishra's movement 1919 to 1934. And this also will not share more pictures. We'll just go to the text work. And I've already discussed with you what will come and what will not. So whatever I'm showing you in this video, it is already been in part of syllabus. So we'll move forward. This is the saying by the Lala Lajpat Rai that every blow struck on me today will be the last nail in the coffin of British rule in India. I have already explained you this thing, so I'm not going to explain now. First we'll need the reaction to the Simon Commission. So reaction to the Simon Commission is basically a reason which led to the launch of the civil disobedience movement. So what happened? Lala Lajpat Rai. So what happened? There's a Simon Commission which was established in 1928 to bring the constitutional reforms in India. But this Simon Commission having a 7-member committee which is having all the British officers. So that's why Indians, they were protesting that it should include one of the Indian leaders. And it led basically when this protest is going on, Lala Lajpat Rai, he struck a lot of blow over his head by the British officers, and it led to death of him. That angered the people and they were okay. Now the next we can say the reason for the launch of civil disobedience movement is the Lahore session. It is holding a very important position. So Lahore session, you know, every year the Congress hold a session at the month of December at a place, and they appoint a president also. So at that time in 1929 there is a Lahore session which held at Lahore on December 1929, and the president was Jawaharlal Nehru. So why this session is important? Because this session is basically decided to boycott the roundtable conferences, because it is basically providing the legislatures to the Indians, but it is basically happening in the London. And second important motive was that to declare the Purin Swaraj, complete independence, as their own resolution. So first was that they decided to boycott the roundtable conference, and second that decided, or they passed the resolution of Purin Swaraj, that is complete independence, as the goal of the Congress. And they took step to launch the civil disobedience movement. So before this, Congress only asking for Swaraj, but this Lahore session, it led to the entry of the Purin Swaraj. So that's why this session is very important. Okay. Now we will move to Dandi March, which led to the the entry or led to the launch of the civil disobedience movement 1930. What happened? The salt law was being enacted by the Britishers, in which the people of the India, they have to purchase the salt, even though they are living into the coastline area where they can produce their own salt. So this salt law has totally, put a lot of tax which the people, poor people, cannot afford to eat the salt also. So Gandhi thought this is the only moment where I can launch the movement. So what happened on 12th March 1930, Mahatma Gandhi with his 78 followers, he started his march from Sabarmati Ashram, which is in Gujarat, to Dandi, which is a village at the coastal area of the Gujarat. And then he advanced, more people joined him, and when he reached Dandi on 6th of April 1930, he picked up the salt by violating the salt law, and he said, this is the salt of my country and I will not pay that. So that, in that way, the civil disobedience movement initiated. So the campaign of breaking of salt of Gandhi was a signal of disobey to the government and laws, and led to the launch of the civil disobedience movement. So this is basically Dandi March. It is also called the March. Okay. Now the Gandhi Indian Pact, as we know, there were 3 roundtable conferences, and these roundtable conferences, all the 3 were organized in London. So first roundtable conference, when it held, so at the time all the congressmen, they were in prison, so they didn't able to join the meeting, and it was a complete failure. So what happened, the Britishers also realized that without Congress we can't pass any kind of legislation. So that's why at the time the Governor General was Lord Irwin, so he signed a pact, an agreement with Mahatma Gandhi that I will provide some promotions, you will provide some promotion, and we will continue with this legislative council's work. Okay. So what happened after the failure of this? There was a pact signed between Gandhiji and the Lord Irwin on 1st March 1931, which is popularly known as Gandhi-Irwin Pact. Now what are the provisions Governor General agreed on? So Governor General, his points we agreed karte, he agreed that I will release all the political prisoners except those of guilty of violence. तो मैं सारे पॉलिटिकल प्रिजनर्स को, जितने नेताओं को मैंने बंद किया, जिन्होंने उन सबको छोड़ दूंगा, उसके अलावा जिन्होंने खून किया उनको, जिन्होंने कोई वॉलेंस किया उनके अलावा, ठीक है. एंड आई विल ऑल्सो गिव बैक द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ ऑल दोज लीडर्स, एंड ऑल्सो अलाउ द पीपल लिविंग द कोस्ट लाइन एरिया टू मैन्युफैक्चर देयर सॉल्ट, एंड अलाउ देम टू यूज पिकेटिंग ऑफ द लिक्योर ऑन द फॉरन फ्लोर शॉप पीसफुली. सो दिस इज बेसिकली द टर्म्स गिवन बाय द गवर्नर जनरल. नाउ महात्मा गांधी, ही अग्रीड बाय दिस, एंड ही सेड इट, आई विल सस्पेंड द सिविल डिसिप्लिन मूवमेंट, एंड आई विल ऑल्सो पार्टिसिपेट द सेकंड राउंड टेबल कॉन्फ्रेंस. So few provisions was given by in this act by the Governor General, and in few provisions Mahatma Gandhi was ready to participate in second round table conference, and he suspended the, we can say, the civil disobedience movement. Okay, now the second roundtable conference, as Mahatma Gandhi promised that I will participate in the second roundtable conference, he went to London, he attended the meeting. But here, when he went there, he basically went with a motive to at least decide a date where the Britishers will provide us freedom or had more constitutional power. But what happened? When he went there, he saw that every person, like there were people from all the community, Muslim community, Sikh community, Indian, Christian, Anglo-Indian, they were demanding for their own seats in the legislature. Nobody is asking for the freedom. So he was very disheartened, and this discussion led to, we can say, a complete failure. So Gandhiji, he was so disgusted to see that nobody is more concerned about the question of the independence. Other than their setting up responsible or setting up a responsible government, they were more focused on their personal interest. So this also turned to be a failure. Second roundtable conference result was that it turned to be a failure, and Gandhiji, he came back to his country with empty hand, and when he came back, he launched the civil disobedience movement. So this is basically the second roundtable conference. Now we'll discuss some questions. What are the reasons for launch of civil disobedience movement? So there were two reasons: the launch of the Simon Commission and also the Lahore session of the Congress. Why was Lahore session of Congress important? Because in that session they decided the Puran Swaraj, they passed the resolution of Puran Swaraj, and also decided to boycott the roundtable conferences. Explain the Salt and Dandi March. The Salt and Dandi March was initiated by Mahatma Gandhi on 12th March 1930 with his 78 followers from the Sabarmati Ashram to Dandi, a village in the Gujarat Sea Coast. 78 followers followed him, and then later the many people joined him. So he reached at Dandi on the 6th of April, where he picked up the salt and break the salt law. And in that way, he initiated the civil disobedience movement. Mention the term of Gandhi is in fact. So the terms were that the Governor General, he was agreed to release all the political prisoners except those who committed the violence, and also give back the properties. He also allowed the people living in the coastal area to make the salt, and also allowed the peaceful picketing of foreign crops. Whereas in the case of Mahatma Gandhi, he agreed to participate into the second roundtable conference and also to suspend the civil disobedience movement. What happened in the second roundtable conference? The second roundtable conference, what happened there was that when Mahatma Gandhi, he went there, he was basically wanted that there should be discussion of the responsible government for the India or the independence of India. But when he went there, he totally disgusted by seeing that people of all the community, they were more focused on their personal interests, and it led to a complete failure. Where were the roundtable conferences took place? The roundtable conferences all took place in London. Now, what were the results of the second roundtable conference? The result was that Mahatma Gandhi went empty hand, it was complete failure, and after he came back, he relaunched the civil disobedience movement. So this is basically the questions which can come from this chapter. Thank you so much.